Hello, check, check, check. This is sound roll number 25. Dayton Ferris, R.E.M. documentary. Minus 8 dB. Level reference follows.
If we're doing the record, star 69.
Yeah, okay.
You might as well just put it down.
I'm trying to, I guess, put all these in first and then figure out where everything else goes around it.
Set, please. Thank you.
Okay, there you go. It's not pretty, but it works.
Where's his room?
This room is the other one back here.
Okay. They're ready for it.
Well, that's the usual.
Michael, we're ready for you.
Bill likes orange crush. You want to stick it in somewhere?
Yeah, I like playing it too.
Make sure that when you come back, it comes back with authority instead of just
right
coming back.
Right.
Easier said than done, but work with it.
That away.
Thank you.
Richard Harrington, by the way.
Hi, Richard. I'm Bill Berry.
Good to see you, man.
Sorry, Bill. I gotta figure out a way to be able to get close to both your mouths.
Just sit on my lap, boy.
Oh, wait a minute. You sit on my coat.
I like a band close
and
like that.
Yeah. So you could sit in the middle and we'll be close. We'll do this. How about that?
This is a free road.
What did they do?
It's okay.
It's okay. Yeah, it was running. Is it running now?
Okay. Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah. 31. Okay. Stop your camera.
Okay.
You guys, we gotta go.
I mean, we got to start it.
We gotta do this. We got a whole day of interviews.
Can it again, homie?
Are we ready?
If we were ready, she wouldn't be in front of him. Just put the mics on.
I have to stay here a half an hour late. It's crazy.
Okay. Is it okay? Is my mic all right?
Yeah. Finally, we're rolling. You psyched? We can finally talk.
All right.
Let's talk about this album. This is incredible. This album has been called sort of an in-your-face album.
The new album. It's loud. All the reviews were saying loud, and I mean, I don't know how different it really is from your older stuff, but certainly the press is saying that it's very different. I wonder what, you know, in general, just it's guitar, for one thing.
Now, from listening to this album, most of the songs on this album, I would have to say, the majority of them, are primarily about love and lust. Would you agree with that? I mean, isn't that the general...
I think I've said that, yeah. Over and over again. Yeah.
Okay. Now,
it's kind of, a lot of records are cerebral, a lot of records are from the heart. This one's more from the crotch. It's kind of a dick record. Can you say dick on...
I don't know. Can we hear
that? There seems to be, you know, quote-unquote sex theme, the sex album, you know, this is like the Black Album or something like that.
Why that part of the anatomy for this album? What was it about that? At this particular time in your lives that you wanted to write most of the songs about love and lust?
Well, we are four men, and as you know, as a woman, most men
sex
spend a great deal of time thinking about their penises. I'm kidding.
That'll play in humor.
Can this air on the
table? That'll go down well. Let's
really,
move on
really
to the next
subject.
Okay, all right. You mean you don't want to talk about this anymore?
No.
Okay. You stand in line, what's the shackles of you? I can understand you are a shark, violent queen. I can understand, I never understood. Don't fuck with me. Another world tour, and it's
going
to be your first one in over 5 years. How do you feel about that?
Excitement.
Yeah, I'm nervous.
Nice. It's just kind of fun to get out and be a kid again. Yeah, I've got new drums, I get to hit them real hard. Pete's got a new amp, and he gets to turn it up all the way, and we can be kids again.
I think all of us kind of realize, you know, that we're probably never going to be in a position like this again. We're probably never going to be as popular and able to do a world tour on this scale. And I'm looking forward to it. I'm gonna have a ball.
On the show, we have 9 projectors, which we built special mirror arrangements, which are operated by the projectionist so they can move the image around over everything, and they'll be used as spotlights and backlights on Michael and the band when they're singing, and also go up onto the screens.
It's going to be fairly low tech. I mean, there'll be visual stuff and nice lights, but it'll be also be kind of hippie-ish, you know. We're not going to have flying pigs and crashing airplanes and the like. It's just not appropriate for what we do. We're more of a performance band rather than a, you know, performance art band. That we'd like to reproduce. You don't have to. You could probably play the songs with just the four of us and they might be okay, but there are a lot of neat little things that we can add and bring to the music by having extra people. So we've got a couple of really nice guys and really good guitar players, and Scott McCoy plays basses and keyboards as well as guitar, and Nathan December is really good. So, you know, it's just gonna be a fuller sound, more fun for everybody, less pressure on Peter to reproduce every note he's ever played.
I feel like this is a real year for us to be completely ambitious, and what we're going to do is tour and ideally record a live record of all new songs. And we have 10 from the last batch that we're kind of working on, and we've written like 3 or 4 in the last rehearsal period, you know, that we don't really know yet, but we're working on. And ideally we'll have 20 things to work on and play, and, you know, I'd love it if next September we're touring America and you know, we have 10 songs in the set that no one's heard.
Thank you. You're too fucking kind.
we're gonna use yellow, let's make it look really piss yellow.
Okay.
Or really like some like grotesque orange yellow.
Okay.
Okay.
No problem.
I have documentary crews following me around everywhere I go, so this conversation is being taped from my end. Maybe we should try to find a clear photograph with Peter and Mike in it, because I think we're a little lacking in them.
Actually, when I went through and counted, Peter beat out both Bill and Mike, surprisingly.
I want them to have enough to put together a great piece, but you know, I don't want them going to the bathroom with me. Front,
yeah.
Back,
yeah.
Cool.
And what?
Filming you on the flight, going back to LA.
Filming me on the flight? No, I will not be filmed on an airplane.
They wanted me to film you on the airplane.
They wanted you to film me. No, forget it.
And I need to know what's going on with Gus Van Sant.
He sent 5 naked boys and a gun, and we're gonna use it.
What I'm worried about is.
Oh, I don't know.
Have you spoken with Gus and told him you want to use it?
Yeah, I left a message for him. I'm gonna meet with him next week.
Okay.
In LA. Hi, it's Mr. Cup calling for my messages or my voicemail. Thank you. I was gonna say hi. I will not be filming an airplane. This documentary thing has gone too far. Do we need to be concerned about getting clearance for? Do you want to raise that to Bert?
I will raise it to Bert. But this is not a retail item.
Right.
So I think we're safe.
Michael is working, man.
You are mobile.
Get out of here.
You are.
I'm faking it.
Yeah. You're doing a good job.
Are you having fun at least?
You're fooling me.
I'm a little tired. I can't sleep. I think this room's only $49 a night. I have no idea what the words are in the chorus, or if there are any.
There may not be any.
High on the roof, something.
High on the roof, I never heard them.
Too young to follow, or something. Who remembers the... Not, offer me solutions, I can't itemize, I can't think clear. What's the other one like that? Oh, boy. Who knows the words? It's something about tiger run around the tree, follow...
Tiger turn into butter.
Right.
Run to turn into butter. It's the end of that one.
What?
It's another one that finds on the waves tonight. That's just something coming
really?
In your home.
Coming in over me. Coming in fast, over me. Whatever.
Every time we tour, we send Microwave out to get all our CDs. We stack them all up, and then we kind of like go through and go, okay, which songs do we want to do? And then we have to play them and relearn them.
Yeah, sure. Tiger run around the tree. Follow the leader, run and turn into butter. Yeah. No, that's a verse that I've been forgetting. I'll do what I've been doing. I need to listen to it.
We've actually had to buy an R.E.M. songbook. Don't tell any. This is, you know.
There you go.
I need lots of other things I want to have. I need an E on here would be good. 1, 2, 3, 4. I need an E flat. I need an E flat, actually, is what I need.
Try it again.
So once you turn it on, you're just going to leave it up, kind of?
I'm going to play it like I did on the record. I'm going to try to. I mean, it's not going to sound great. Be prepared for that, you know. So, that's why I call it rehearsal. All right, let's try it. Don't be shocked by anything you hear.
Keys cut, 3, 4, the price of one. Nothing's free again, empty for a lifetime's use. I've changed the locks, and you can.
There's a song on Automatic called Star Me Kitten, which was our treatment of it on the record was sort of inspired by like 10cc and like vocal tape loops.
Again?
I sang about 8 different notes and we sampled them and then we loaded them onto a track, each note onto one track of the 8-track machine. So when I raise the fader, that note comes up, so I'm actually sort of playing the mixing board to get the notes, and it's sort of just the 10cc effect that they did on I'm Not in Love. So we're going to try to reproduce that live and see if it works.
You are wild, and I'm in your possession. Nothing's free, so fuck me.
I mean, it could go like one note longer. I'm still singing when you guys stop. Yeah, that'd be great. How does that sound? It's kind of twisted, huh?
It sounds like it's going to be really good.
We have to find someone that we can trust to make a sound the way we want to sound. And Scott can do that. So right now, he's our ears. And he's out there telling us how bad things sound. And
I'm worried that you're going to have too much to do over there.
I think what I need to do is get more notes on there and lose the organ and try to do it with just the voices.
Or else if there's a mix, like when we make the notes, we mix the organ with the voice of each of those. And then you can just play the mixer.
That's fine, too.
If you'd told us before we met him that we would pick a producer that we like so much that we'd do 6 consecutive records with, and we'd tell you we're crazy. But he really does work with us that well. He's very versatile, and melodically, he has the same sort of sensibilities we do, and he understands what we want and how to get that sound. And he's easy to work with. He's a great guy, and we've broken him in, as Pete says.
Over the years, having seen you go through various changes as a performer, there seemed to be sort of a point where it wasn't so much that you seemed to be embarrassed to be up there, but you certainly didn't seem very comfortable. And then gradually you seemed to become increasingly comfortable. And then you seemed to sort of become something of an entertainer and showman. Then suddenly you're off the road for 5 years. Where do you see yourself in that continuum now as a performer?
My goal on the next tour is to stand stock still and not speak between songs. And be a singer.
Yeah. That's an interesting.
It's not going to happen.
Yeah.
also dedicated a song to Kurt Cobain.
Well, I wrote the song about him, yeah. Yeah. Well, I just kind of had to get it off my chest. It was, I mean, when he died, it pretty much brought everything to a screeching halt in terms of the making of the record.
The song, Let Me In, does that become a difficult song to sing now?
Yeah, it is hard. The guitar that Mike plays on it, do you mind me saying this? The guitar that Mike plays on it is Kurt's guitar that Courtney gave us after his death. And I can imagine that going in front of a group of 20,000 people who were probably Nirvana fans and performing that song is going to be pretty emotional.
I was like, Mike, I insist you play guitar, and no drums. We're not going to have, this isn't going to be a band thing. It's going to be that. And then Michael goes, well, Peter, you play keyboards then, since you don't know how to play keyboards. It's like, great, I could play with, you know, index finger method. I kind of mirrored the melody line, but also twisted it a little bit. And, you know, I wanted a cheesy organ sound because, you know, I wanted that roller rink kind of sadness feel.
I'm Michael.
Hi, how are you, sir? My name is Raphael.
Hey, Raphael. Raphael, is this phone 212?
No, this is 917. You have to dial 212.
Okay.
And then once you hit the send button, so that we don't get cloned, press recall 01, send again.
So I dial the number first, and then I do the...
Right, so, dial the number, press send, and once you hear the two rings, then hit recall 01 and send again.
Okay.
Does he have to do 1, 2,
is it 1, 2, 1, 2?
Yes, 1, okay. 2, 1, 2.
This is really confusing. Did you say so that we don't get cloned?
Yes, because what happens is everyone has been getting cloned lately. And
been cloned. Hey, Michael, it's Michael calling. It's 11:45, and I'm on my way to Barolo. That's where we're doing 120 minutes. If you want to come down and hang out, I'm going to be there until 2 o'clock, and I'd love to see your face. If not, then I'll see you tonight. All right? And if you want to, you can come on and tell a story about Veruca Salt. That'll be cool. Bye. Oh, you know what? I want to come up with, we need a quorum here, because I'm not going to introduce myself as Michael Stipe. So we've got Kojak. King of Siam, who played that?
Yul Brynner.
Mr. Clean.
Mr. Clean.
I think Mr. Clean has an S&M thing on the side. He was pretty weird.
Does it have to be a man?
No. Come on. Valerie. Right. No, we're equal opportunity. Satirist. Give us a hand here, Raphael. Who else?
So what are we looking for? Bald people?
Yeah.
one that's bald, huh?
Oh, Sigourney Weaver.
Yes, man. Cool. Sigourney Weaver. Okay, who else should I be?
Oh, Mason. Anthony Mason.
Anthony Mason, who's that?
He's with the Knicks. He's a basketball player with the Knicks. He's bald.
I've never heard of him.
Okay.
That was a good call. Anthony, man, he needs to get on some magazine covers or something.
This is actually the first time that that I've driven Michael, but I was at the MTV Awards.
Because
I drove Mr. Bennett, Tony Bennett. And I saw Michael there and all that.
I happen to like this story. I think it's College Rock. Glory. So this chord change.
He was an honest man.
Michael's great. I mean, I've loved his music ever since he came out. I mean, you know, it's he has a nice, sweet voice, you know, and it's like that without any gimmicks at all. It's all natural, which is really impressive because a lot of artists today, you know, they sound great once they're in the studio. Once you take them out of the studio and put a live mic in front of them, you know, they sound totally different. It's like night and day, but Mike was true to form.
She heard him say, Brandy, you're a fine girl. What a good wife you would be.
What's misogyny?
Life, my love and my lady is the sea.
Ooh. Okay, enough of that.
What song in the song are you most proud of?
Tongue.
I got it.
We all have.
Michael does plan this stuff out. I mean, we'll talk about it. He goes, you know, I'm going to write about love this record, or I'm going to write about, you know, sex. This record is the least from his character. Because, you know, like, the last record, that was, like, if Michael didn't write about himself or things he's been through, but I could, knowing him, I could go, okay, that's his perspective on this. This record is not his perspective. I mean, Tongue is sung by a woman, you know, which is kind of, I guess, why he did the falsetto.
I mean, as soon as he becomes comfortable with something, he invents something else to be nervous about. It, it,
he'll worry about like either a visual thing or, you know, he'll just convince himself that his voice isn't sounding right. So he makes these changes.
The other thing is he hates his voice.
Yeah.
Just hates it. Hates it. It's always like cover it with reverb or put it through a speaker or something, right. But don't let it sound like this. Which is really funny because, you know, as far as I'm concerned, he's like the best, you know, white rock and roll singer that's alive now. You know, I think Michael has an amazing voice, and he's always, like, trying to hide it, to cover it up, to, you know. And that's just that kind of weird thing. I mean, you know, he wants to be the front man, but he also wants his voice buried and reverbed and, you know. There's one line that he likes that I do in this song, and it's only one note. And I was like, go ahead, play it. Enjoy yourself.
This is the only volume control.
Okay.
See, that means you just have one pickup, so this right here is it.
So I just go like that and then
hit it. Yeah, there you go.
We've gained a few. Peter had twins, Zoe and Zelda.
Congratulations.
I didn't redo that much.
But you did enough.
Whatever
you did, it worked.
You're doing it now, anyway.
Yeah, you're making up for it.
I have two new kids, twins, that just like Dad, they do not sleep at night.
Yeah.
They do not sleep. And they are awake. They're awake every hour there is. And, you know, it's really weird. You'd think babies would have to sleep sometime, but they don't.
That'll bring a, you know, degree of normalcy to the whole thing. And it's kind of cool because they're at an age where they'll start the tour, they'll just barely be crawling.
So they should, by the time the tour's over, they should be walking and starting to say, like, Dad, Dad, Mama, and stuff. So that's going to be kind of fun to watch that.
How nice to grow up on the road with a bunch of uncles.
See, it's great because I'm in this band. These guys are my best friends. And it's really great because, like, we flew up here together from Atlanta where we rehearsed, like,
It was like baby tossing.
Yeah, it was like, anyone want this one? You know, and I just like hand them. But they're really good with it. I mean, every parent in the world thinks that they have the best babies in the world, and I just don't see why I should be any different.
Someone mentioned that one of the things that they thought about R.E.M. is that it's a band that sort of can appeal to the sort of 14-year-old nephew who won't listen to anything but Megadeth, and also, you know, it's not something that your mother's going to necessarily change the station on. It can still have this sort of hip credentials, and, you know, I wonder if that's...
We need to work on that.
Bill, can I get a picture with you?
Bill, can I get a picture with you?
I gotta go. Sorry.
Tight schedule.
Thank you.
Please.
I believe I'm wearing my outfit right now. Pretty much, here it is.
How long did it take you?
This was an all-day thing. I ruminated a lot. I didn't have a lot of laundry. A lot of choices.
Who is that?
Just fall in with
it. Like, call him. Like, yeah, please.
Hey, that was a good idea. Did you have a day?
Yes. As far as I'm concerned, you can. I don't know if they'll let you. Whose was that? That's yours.
Back, please don't block this exit.
He said it may take a decade. You're gonna return America to a more black and white.
Yeah, and no political messages. Although, if you made up a t-shirt for me that said no nude is good nude, I would wear it.
I'll see what I can do.
We hate Newt Gingrich.
Saturday?
No, we're doing three songs. It'll be cool. It's gonna be really cool though because one of them is Bang and Bling.
That's the song, then a commercial, then a sketch, and then
we also got this band shot.
Oh, right, where they're gonna play with
you. Yeah, so there's all kinds of shit going on. We just gotta be on our toes the whole time.
I like 3 and 6.
Are we going to do all of them?
No, we won't do all of them, but I just need to know if there's something that you won't do.
Hi, I'm Sarah Jessica Parker, and I'll be hosting Saturday Night Live with musical guest R.E.M., four fine southern gentlemen. Okay, who pinched my butt?
Sorry.
They'll probably try to get as many as they can. They'll just go through them.
I'm Sarah Jessica Parker. I live in NYC. I'm a member of the ACLU, and I'm a proud member of NOW. I'll be hosting SNL with R.E.M. on NBC, okay? Okay.
Well, one is out.
One is out.
Okay, one is out, and...
You know what? Why don't you say it? I just don't feel like talking. I just hate voice. I'll be happy standing there. Someone else can do it. I just don't feel like talking.
Okay, so any one of you guys will take Peter's lines.
Sarah Jessica Parker, R.E.M., Saturday Night Live. Ow!
Hey, Sarah, did you hurt your arm?
Hey, everybody hurts sometime, Michael. Get it? That's your song.
There's still time to cancel.
Should I nix number one?
Number one's okay.
I don't know. What do you think, Michael?
If you don't like it, though,
I just think a lot of people aren't going to get that.
Hi, I'm Sarah Jessica Parker, and I'm hosting Saturday Night Live this week with special musical guest R.E.M. Speedwagon.
That's just R.E.M.
Whatever.
Not real thrilled about
that's eight. Nine minutes.
Are you kidding? This is going to be our first show in a Republican Congress, and we looked utterly deadpan. Wow. Yeah, things are going to be so different now. In fact, this week, the show is going to be on at 11:30. Wow.
Now let's go see what it looks like.
Okay, so what am I saying now?
This is so we can go in the automatic change lane on the turnpike. We're trying to get Nathan to ride in the first bus so that we can just pluck the money. It's a new accounting principle. Our accountants have asked us to keep track of every dime.
Just now, they were just fooling around. They're going to do the first song in a second. First song in the show. Yeah.
Stand by, please. Five seconds. Holding. Ladies and gentlemen, R.E.M.
No, but that's ticketed as well. There's not, you can't even get in for that. We have X amount of people, and we don't have any. Exactly, you can't do it. Sorry, I have to go now. They're sound checking. Thanks. What? Are they going to where? We don't know what the plans are for after the show. Thanks very much. Okay.
You want makeup?
No.
Only wear makeup from when we're dressed.
Norman, are you shooting this?
Oh, sure.
What?
Son's a big fan.
Cool, that's great. How old is he?
Might be. We don't know.
32.
I'm still older than your son.
So you don't know.
Don't tell anybody.
I will.
Michael, hi. My name is Paul. It's a pleasure to meet you. I was wondering if I could get you John Hancock on this nice...
Let me put my dinner down.
Oh, sure.
All of you. Is everyone here?
I can only speak for myself.
Thank you.
Okay, that goes.
This goddamn pen, I mean, I think it's the angle or something. All right, that's the trouble. So now it's engraved.
It's engraved.
It's better than just
there you go.
Hand etched. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. It's a nice one.
Yeah. What's that on your thumb?
It's a tattoo. It's growing out.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It used to be a question mark, but it grew out.
Wow.
Yeah.
Cool.
See ya.
Thank you.
How'd you get?
I don't know. We just kind of slipped in. Yeah. We handed the guy at the gate a little Jamaican.
Norm MacDonald, you're up.
What is that, by
the way? Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up.
I can't decide whether to wear this or this on top of it.
Well, you should wear one with that on top and one not. I didn't actually bring
three, I know. I brought three
changes, but
this
I brought...
This is just so boring.
I don't know. I don't see my coat off or something.
Are you cold?
No, theoretically, we're going to all wear different outfits every time, and I didn't believe
we're wearing different clothes for every song.
Oh. Well, they got all kinds of crazy stuff in there.
Well, I hear the
machine's head
fun.
Here, here. Here, I'll show you head. Here, I'll show you.
I don't want to watch it. But mine other check as well, that one.
You can only do one, huh?
Yeah, that's all I got, yeah. Go ahead, I'll sneak in somehow, some other way.
You gotta have more stuff.
Oh, yeah?
We need a jacket for Peter Bob.
Okay, this is Tom. James, where's Tom?
What's he, 44?
In there. Yeah. Tom?
Whose are all these ones, Dan?
Kiss.
That's flattering. Yeah. Are you using these tonight? Hi.
Hi.
They've got to have some more costume changes.
Oh.
Yeah, because they're in from out of town. They don't have much.
Are you the coat man?
I am.
Do you have any fake fur?
Anything
like this? Is this somebody's right here?
It would be like the other room.
This is somebody's real coat?
Yeah. But I have another coat like that.
That's a good looking coat, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
That says welcome ashore.
Yeah.
Could I try this
one? We have another. Yeah.
That one is a nice one.
There's also this, which is a matte suit.
Oh, that's pretty groovy.
Yeah. For yourself?
This one actually might fit better.
It's slimming.
Where are you guys watching?
I don't know, this is like very weird.
Keep getting kicked around, you know.
It's not really a place that you're like allowed to.
We're supposed to be VIPs. We were being treated like, you know, the water boy. That's all right, I like being treated that way. I know.
We were looking for the room where they had all the sushi. And we couldn't find that room.
Yeah, bye.
Well, I figure I'd start there and work down.
I'll give you a bunch of little passes.
Okay.
And you hand them out as you see fit.
Okay.
The band and your crew won't need them.
Right.
And you'll all have vehicles.
Okay.
In the basement.
Okay.
And so as they don't get mobbed.
Right.
Yeah.
Cool.
There
Thanks, Tom.
Sure.
It's really manic.
It is. And they think they do this every week.
Yeah.
I know. You get that way. I mean, it must be like doing a play, except you have to rewrite it every week.
Okay. Put on some shoes. A little bit of lip gloss, and I'm motherfucking on!
Live from New York, it's Saturday night!
Yeah, these pants. Okay.
So just
the pants from both of those. Okay. Nope.
I never
heard of that. R.E.M. Start coming to the studio.
Hey guys, this is our cue.
No, this is
one.
I got some.
Saturday Night Live? Totally. I mean, it's the spontaneity and energy, you know, you can't find anywhere else. There's no other show that goes live. You go out, you have a minute and a half to set yourself, and you play live in front of millions of people. And it's like, boom, that's your shot, and that's that.
Dream of Galveston.
Then it goes one more time. Bam, 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 wow. Bam, 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 bam.
It's so weird. He just drops beats all over the place.
Actually, when we were making Monster, we were in Miami, and we had a night off, and I know this really, really, really tacky bar, and I won't name the name, because it's a really, the people that work there are fun, it's really nice, but it's at the bottom of a hotel, and it's totally Miami, and they had karaoke night, and Michael got up and just blew away all these people by doing Jimmy Webb songs, and I was just like, well, you know, we really ought to do one of those on the road, and he was like, sure, no problem.
I learned it in the wrong key.
Yeah,
exactly.
Oh my God.
Such a successful thing going, how can you even think about breaking up? Is that something that you do think about?
Only when journalists bring it up.
Did we ever?
We're on the same team, but we're not always on the same page. We're four very distinct people. We admire and appreciate each other a great deal, usually. And all those differences put together are R.E.M. If any one of us were to leave this couch right now, the other two would be more comfortable. But we would not be R.E.M. anymore.
Stop pushing. That's a really good thing. I mean, I knew these guys would, and you know, Michael was still a teenager when we met, you know. And it's kind of cool that we're growing up and, you know, we're different people now, and the fact that we've been able to work together and be adults about this, you know, I think it's a great experience. You know, just aside from the making the music, it's kind of interesting to, most people don't have a job where they stay with the same people for 15 years.
Still on the line.
Okay. See you tomorrow at 1.
See you later.
Bye.
You guys, I'm sitting out this one. Do you know that? I'm sorry.
And this record was just, you know, it was supposed to be simple and spontaneous and rough. And it's kind of cool how few of the songs are like really constructed all that well. I mean, they're consciously written simply, you know. And yeah, I wasn't trying to impress
anybody. Basically, tried to use every stupid rock and roll cliche. And we just about did it. I mean, except that there are 14, there's only 12 songs on the record. So there's two more cliches out there, but we'll get that on the next record.
There are 14.
There are 14 cliches, yeah.
But I haven't heard that. That's the
number that comes to mind for me.
I agree with that. There's 14 rock and roll cliches. But you know, one of them is long permed hair on older men, and we're not ready for that yet. But we might use it on the cover of the next record.
Sounds fair enough. All right. Well, thank you very much.
Sure. Thanks.
Sure.
Thanks.
Thank you. Thanks. Okay. Thanks. Oh, thanks for your
question. Not too bad.
Thank you. It was fun. I really enjoyed it. It was really quick, but I think I did stuff. Thank you. Bill. Thanks, Bill. I appreciate it. Thanks.
Thanks, Richard.
Take care. That's it. Oh.
Man, you guys sound great.
Together?
Really. It sounds great. You look great. It's true. If I wasn't in this band, I think I would, I'd like be a big fan. You know, I'd go see us live. I would be irritated by me every now and then, but I think I would like, I think I would like us a lot.